Hello, everyone. Thank you for joining us this morning, this afternoon, evening, wherever you are in the world. My name is Sarah Murray. I'm our United States Hospitality Leader for Lutron Electronics. I'm joined here by my colleague, Javier Segovia, who is our Senior Director of Global Hospitality for Lutron. We are the Forbes Travel Guide brand official for light, shade, and temperature control since 2018. And today, we're very excited to share with you some of the new and exciting ways that hoteliers are using light to drive both their revenue and their business goals. Our colleagues, Lori Christofferson and Jill Noga, are also with us. They're gonna be monitoring the chat. So if you have any questions as we go through it, please feel free to jot it in there and your question will be answered. We also have three poll questions that we would love for you to participate in as we have a great spread of the industry here today. And then at the very end, you'll have an opportunity to provide feedback. So if there's any questions that you didn't get answered or if you'd like more information, you'll be able to submit that form as well. As we get going here, we want you to leave today feeling inspired about the possibilities of light, especially as we start to kind of resume and prepare for a future that is still unfolding in a post-pandemic world. So without further ado, let's get going. You welcome guests from all over the world, and the expectations for luxury are only increasing. Lighting in a hotel is challenging. You have multiple restaurants, you have a wedding in the ballroom upstairs, you have conference rooms going on. It is a very functioning environment that needs to change rapidly based on space type and time of day. And one of the biggest trends we're seeing is that guests are looking for personalization and differentiated experiences, even if they're staying on property. So hotels have long understood the importance of lighting for ambiance. But with new solutions and technologies, we are now starting to see going beyond ambiance to make light an amenity, something that delivers more than was ever thought possible with some of the solutions in the past. So today, we're going to cover four main opportunities. We have many that we could talk about, but we thought these would be the most relevant for you today. The first is how to attract foot traffic to increase your food and beverage and retail spend. The second is maximizing flexibility to really increase that special events revenue. The third is creating Instagram moments to draw visitors. And then the fourth is differentiating your guest room to attract repeat business. And with that, I'm going to pass it over to my colleague Javier to walk us through our first opportunity.
Hola from Madrid. Well, the first impression you can make on a guest is with exterior facade. Here we have the opportunity to use lighting to attract local foot traffic and all the tourists to come in, enjoy a coffee, a cocktail, or even a nice meal. The intention here is to increase your food and beverage revenue. For example, at the VIP Hotel here in Madrid, the exterior facade has a dynamic lighting, fun to watch, and for sure a good way to catch attention. You also have an amazing metal sculpture in the lobby that drives a lot of interest and visits. This is one of the places I normally visit when people come to see me. Sarah, that's where we need to go when you come along. The other place is the Four Seasons Hotel, because of the facade. And then usually you can enjoy a whole day in town, enjoying the city, and finish the day in one of those restaurants or in the top roof having a gin and tonic. The other story with Four Seasons is in the hotel in Philadelphia. In this case, it's quite interesting because lighting is used to define areas, to separate the spaces and communicate where to find the bar or the reception. The idea is to drive the traffic to your convenience, again, inviting clients to your areas like cocktail, cafeteria, and restaurants. And all this is very discreet. From the elevator, you can find a bright but warm lighting that is going to drive you to the registration area. And suddenly you can have amazing views and you can have the typical accent lighting under the bar that is going to drive you to the restaurant. This visual lighting helps your guests to feel relaxed, to feel safe and comfortable. And this is also going to help you with the Forbes Travel Standard guidelines. And then here, for example, you have the Arrival 919, one of the Forbes Travel Guide standards, and the lighting taking you to the registration desk is what we are trying to do here. This is going to bring us now to the first question we have for today, as Sarah mentioned earlier, and it is regarding the dynamic lighting. And then, do you have dynamic lighting on your hotel facades? The answer could be yes, and people love it. Yes, but nobody really notices. No, or I don't even know. We have today around 600 people registered. I don't know how many people we have online today, but we are expecting a lot of answers from you. Please feel free to give us answers and give your opinion with these questions regarding the dynamic lighting in the facade. 39%, they do and they love it. 30%, they don't. 17%, they do, but nobody notices. And it seems that they don't even know we have a 14%. Well, thank you for your answers, and let's go back to LA with Sarah.
Thanks, Javier. So this next method is really a story about flexibility. In every single environment, hotels are dynamic spaces that need to function 24/7. So lighting and control technologies can help maximize your spaces by creating the appropriate light levels throughout the day for different occasions. As Javier mentioned, his favorite properties in Madrid, I'd like to share one of my favorites from my home, Los Angeles, and this is the Nomad Hotel in downtown LA. The Nomad is a restored historic building that was former home to the Bank of Italy. One thing that's really special about this particular bank was that it was one of the first banks in the city to allow women and minorities to open bank accounts, though they had to use the mezzanine level. This central atrium you see here is the core of multiple functions throughout the day. It's a restaurant open for breakfast, lunch, and dinner. It's a lounge for business meetings and happy hours. And then this mezzanine level that I mentioned is open for private events and dinner service. There are also two bars that flank either side of this area entry. So in this atrium, the lighting will change from breakfast to dinner to a 3 a.m. cleaning scene without any manual intervention from the staff. So this really keeps the team focused on guest service and not having to play lighting designer. As the lighting slowly evolves throughout the course of the day, it's not noticeable to the guests. All they feel is a continuous sense of relaxation and perfect ambiance. And of course, because we are in Los Angeles, this property is often rented for filming movies and TV shows, and that's something that we're seeing in other markets as well, as film production is being spread throughout the US. Of course, we would be remiss if we didn't mention special events. So when there are needs for special event settings, like a concert or a party, the staff can use an intuitive iPad software to pre-schedule the lighting changes in advance. So in 2019 and 2020, the hotel was rented for a Grammy party. This is Dua Lipa, you see on the screen here. With just lighting, the lobby was able to be transformed into a performance stage. So the director of engineering was able to schedule the time clock and event. All of the architectural lighting controlled by the Lutron system turned off. At the same time, the theatrical lighting turned on. So it gives the events director and the engineering team that convenience, but also peace of mind. And then with the seamless transitions, you're able to really resume back to your regularly scheduled program as soon as the event is over. It's really neat to see how different technologies are being deployed to do these quick changes. And then one last example from the Nomad is that this flexibility gives you the opportunity to do more within your space. So the Nomad Cafe that you see here has a lobby entrance and a street entrance, and there's coffee shop, croissants, and pastries during the day. And then at nighttime, happy hour, it turns into a really fun bar. So we're ensuring that those food and beverage dollars can be captured almost around the clock from guests, but also from people commuting to and from work and drawing in that foot traffic opportunity that Javier discussed. There was actually an article in LA Magazine shortly after the hotel opened called How to Eat and Drink Around the Clock at the Nomad Hotel. And this is relevant for both guests and locals in the city. I personally, if you have come to visit me in Los Angeles, a colleague or a client, you have probably dined either breakfast, lunch, or dinner at this property. It is a really special space. And then recently, Lutron launched a new lighting solution that offers the ability to mimic natural light in interior spaces while creating saturated color scenes from the same light source. So this lamp and lighting technology is called Ketra. And so imagine the type of power to be able to bring that natural light indoors. We recently worked with a property that had a basement bar that didn't open until 8 p.m. They are now renting the bar out during the daytime as a meeting space to drive revenue, and the ability to have those flexible lighting capabilities were really crucial. And then one last trend that we're seeing, and I'm sure you guys at your properties have had the same inquiries, but we're seeing the use of ballrooms used for business meetings to accommodate social distance measures. But the warm, romantic lighting that you'd see in a ballroom for weddings and special events is much, much different than the lighting you'd want for a bright and energized business event. Most ballrooms do not have windows either, so the ability to bring natural light into the space is also really important. And there are many different color tuning technologies available. I just want to explain a little bit what color tuning means. The ability to have a light source that has a warm to cool output based on the needs of your property within the same fixture is what we mean when we say tunability and dynamic. But this is kind of a fun story. Javier recently attended an event at the VP Madrid where the ballroom was used for this exact purpose, and the lighting was able to be adjusted for the conference. You can see on their iPad there, and then these were the guests at the event. So if there is one thing that you take away with from today, it's that flexibility in your lighting system can not only support those revenue goals, but it can really be a positive impact on your bottom line for years to come. So this takes us to our second of three poll questions. Do areas of your property serve multiple purposes at different times of day? And your answers are yes, and the lighting changes. Yes, and the lighting stays the same. No, but I see opportunities, or no, I'm not sure where I need this. All right, more than 50% lighting changes throughout the course of the day. Very neat. I hope that some of the examples that we gave from the Nomad was inspiring. If you don't see the lighting change, definitely flexibility is crucial, and it seems like half of our team here, half of our group is already using that same type of flexible system. So that's wonderful. So we're gonna go on to our third opportunity. This is a pretty fun one. You may or may not have heard the term Instagram moment. I know Javier just learned it, but he's in Spain. It is becoming a widely known fact that the hospitality industry is engaging visitors to capture those social media snapshots. And it is a great way to attract more business, differentiate your property, and create that unique social media marketing opportunity. The idea of making something within your hotel a destination ultimately makes your hotel a destination. And so using dynamic lighting is a great way to enhance and personalize those Instagram moments. One amazing example is the Catch restaurant in Las Vegas at the Aria Resort and Casino. There's this really beautiful, stunning floral wall entryway, and it has Catcher light throughout the space, but it's perfect for that social media post. So much so that guests will arrive 30 minutes early just to make sure that they have time to capture the perfect shot. And then, of course, they eat dinner at the restaurant, and then maybe they go gamble for a bit and go to the nightclub. It really is an interesting way to draw in that traffic. And the lighting is finely tuned to make both the guests and the installation look their best, almost like a real-life Instagram filter. One of the things that Javier and I keep hearing throughout the pandemic is that as travel resumes, guests may be a little bit more weary to go out and explore the local markets or go on local tours. So hotels are needing to find creative ways to add programming to keep guests on property and feeling safe. And this is a really great way to engage. And then another way that we see lighting used for social media moments, and I'm sure you've seen this too, is on the step and repeats or for pop-up event installations. I don't know if you were able to attend the Forbes Travel Guide Gala last year, but we invited guests into our pop-up speakeasy photo booth and encouraged them to toggle between different lighting scenes. One thing that's interesting about the color output is that there are great ways to add more engagement when selling corporate and private events. So imagine how useful it would be for branding if you were sponsoring T-Mobile conference at your property to have the ability to do a T-Mobile pink or a Disney blue. This also helps you differentiate from the properties next door, potentially looking to book the same business. And then speaking of branding, last year we partnered with Careers Through Culinary Arts Program, CCAP, on their annual benefit at Chelsea Piers. As the chairman was about to give his speech, all of the lights turned red, CCAP's signature color, and it highlighted the stage. It was such a cool visual cue for all of the attendees to kind of stop what they were doing and pay attention to the speakers. Once the speeches were done, the lighting resumed to its original settings, and each chef had a customized control over their stations. And as you can imagine, the lighting above the dessert station was much more warm, dimmed, whereas the lighting over the sushi station really needed to be cool and natural. So of course, lighting impacts how food looks as well. So I'm going to pass it back to Javier to review our final opportunity. We're going to take it up to the guest rooms.
Thank you, Sarah. Well, guest rooms, differentiating your property with lighting is not only for public areas. Guest rooms are very important. Now that travel will be back, we believe that the first travelers will be the luxury leisure ones and also the high-end professional ones. And then the bar has been raised, the expectations are higher. I think the traditional amenities like toiletries or coffee makers are not enough. And you need to show something else. And then how are you going to differentiate your property? You must personalize the guest room experience versus the competition and elevate this experience, adding value in every corner. You will have a welcome light when you arrive to the room. The shades are going to open. You will have a very nice light that is going to come on. But after, you can have different ambience. You may have an ambience dim for relaxing. You may have another one for working. And of course, you will have a blackout and a darkness experience to sleep properly. An amazing example of this is the Equinox Hotel in New York City. In this case, the way they market the hotel is very interesting. They talk about a dark, quiet, and cool oasis. And they also talk about some terms like residential living, soundproofing. This is what your customers are expecting right now. Equinox isn't marketing the technology as such. Technology must work for you. And then the idea is that you can create the value that technology is going to bring. And then when we are talking about the dark, quiet, and cold oasis, we're talking about sleeping properly, about enjoying and relaxing. The guest experience and room controlling becomes then a complement to the brand, and showing differentiation, staying ahead of the competition is key. If I am a business traveler and I need to choose between two hotels, between the traditional one with amenities and these ones, I think my debate is gone. I think I will for sure will go with something like this. The other thing what is very important is that the guest room, in addition to find a way to personalize the experience, you need to find a way to give power to your guest. And then we are being asked all the time if we can control our systems to enough. The answer is yes. However, it doesn't have to be one way or another. We want to give the possibility to your guests to go to the traditional keypad and thermostat in the wall, or you can go to an app. For example, this one is the Virgin Hotel in Dallas and Nashville, and then we're integrating with the Lucy app, with the Virgin app. In this case, the guests can control it from the thermostat in the wall or from the app, and can control the lights from the keypad in the wall or from the app. When we are thinking about lighting, don't forget also about the daylight, because that's very important. Shades and drapery are critical for the overall light experience. And then during the day, you want a lot of natural lighting coming in, filling the room. However, at night, when you want to sleep, you want the opposite. You want to be able to have total darkness, a blackout shade, and be able to sleep properly. The idea is to blend interior and exterior to elevate the comfort, but everything in a very easy way. Something as simple as controlling the blackout shades from your bed can have a sense of luxury. This one, for example, is the Set Hotel in London. This one is a mid-tier segment hotel. It's not exactly luxury, but the sense of luxury you have here is amazing. And this is what really your clients are after. This is your competition. And then the guests are expecting something like this to elevate the experience and elevate the comfort. Especially in guest rooms, lighting is critical and can be elevated to amenity. Something like dimming is a simple way to add luxury, and you can personalize the environment. If lighting light doesn't feel right, it's quite difficult to fix. And then we believe that when you are working in a project, when you are designing a room, you need to be thinking about this from the beginning, because once it is built, it's more difficult to do it. And then design it properly in order to build it properly. Market technology as an amenity that delivers an experience is a way to separate yourself from the competition. And what is also very important is when you talk about lighting and temperature control, these systems will pay by itself, because the reality is that you have an ROI that is going to help you to pay for the investments. I think with this, I think we're covering all the points we wanted to cover today. These are the four travel guide standards that we covered today with lights, natural lighting and artificial lighting. And I really like to thank you for your attendance today. For us, lighting is very serious and we think we can help. Sarah, I think we're back to LA.
Yes, so we have a final poll question after Javier walked us through the guest room integration. On a scale of 1 to 5, how important is light, including lighting and shading, to your guest room experience? We have 1 is not important, 2 not something we prioritize, 3 somewhat important, very important, or a top priority in our hotels. So Jill's going to open up our poll here. Go ahead and vote 1 through 5. All right, kind of what we were expecting, very important and a top priority. I think this is something that we've seen in the industry too. If lighting is not right, it's something that can be a pain point. So we appreciate your feedback. And it seemed to be right in line with all of our industry trends and the clients that we work with. So we are rounding out our presentation here. You know, in closing, we wanted to just cover those four key opportunities one more time. You know, dynamic lighting can address various needs for different areas of the hotel, and we have the whole hotel to play with. So we are here to help you consider how lighting and technology can help make you money or save you money by attracting foot traffic to increase food and beverage spend, maximize flexibility, create on-site destinations with those Instagram moments or engagement moments, and then differentiate your guest rooms to attract repeat business. You know, we only covered a certain areas of the hotel, but imagine, you know, this type of impact on the spa and restaurant applications. There's a lot happening that we've seen, and it's been really fun to be a part of. So we would love to hear from you. Please reach out to us. Our contact information is provided here, along with our Instagram handle if you want to engage with us on social media, online, or on LinkedIn. I'd also, you know, we'd really like to extend a very special thanks to the Forbes Travel Guide team for hosting us today. It's been a really fun partnership, and we continue to work and be a part of our industry. We look forward to speaking with you soon.